I very recently became aware of a new feature inside of Generative Fill in Photoshop Beta. Now, this is a very tiny thing that'd be easy to miss, but man, it makes a difference when you use it. Let's jump in and have a look right now. At the time of this recording, this feature is only available inside the Photoshop Beta. To get it, go up to your Creative Cloud, that would be at the bottom on Windows, choose Apps, you'll see Beta, and then you'll just install the Photoshop Beta. So in this image, we're going to generate a Vespa bike, but I want to show you this almost hidden new feature that really makes things a lot easier. So why don't we start with making a selection around the area that we want this Vespa to be. I'll just make a rough selection around here. And make sure your taskbar is shown. If you don't see it, then just go under there and then choose contextual taskbar under window. And then we're going to hit generate a fill. Now I could type in Vespa and, well, why don't we do this? And see what we get. Okay, that's not what I was looking for. Neither is that, neither is that. Okay, let's undo this. All right, so that definitely didn't give us what we were looking for. What we can do is choose generator fill. This time we're going to use a reference image. So when you see this box will pop up, we choose image, and then we can navigate, we can find an image, and I have one here of a Vespa. And I can just close it there. You can see it's loaded with a little blue icon. And I generate. We're going to see a little bit of a problem. And part of the reason is that is if you don't have an isolated background on your image, it doesn't always generate a good, clean image. But let's see what it does. Okay, so it's doing a pretty good job of generating that Vespa, but we've got this background behind it. All right, so let's make a selection around here. All right, so let's hit generative fill. Let's load in the image, and we're going to hit choose image. Here's our scooter. Now, in order to get a better selection, normally we remove the background before we use the reference image. But here's the new option. Look at this little button here. It says remove background. If we click on that, it's going to remove the background for us inside the reference image, and now it's ready for use. So let's generate. And as you can see, now it's generating our Vespa right here without putting some kind of a strange background in there. And if you're getting any value out of this video, hit that subscribe button, turn on notifications, you won't miss any of my videos. Okay, so let me give you a little bonus tip here. If we wanted to show the real city behind it, what we will do is just grab the object or the quick selection tool, either one of those, and then we're going to choose, under the option, we're going to choose cloud, and we're going to click select subject. All right, so now what we've done is we've loaded in the selection. Notice this, it's on its own layer. If we look behind it, that whole selected area is going to be generated. So all we've got to do is inverse that selection, which is Command-Shift-I. And then if we paint with black, where we paint with black, it'll show the layer underneath. So let's just grab a brush. I'll make it a little bit bigger here. And notice as I paint this away, let's get a soft edge brush. Take that hardness all the way down. Here we go. And now we can just paint in the original background. Look at that. And I'll just let it kind of blend in with the new foreground, because the reason for that is I want to keep those shadows that it's generated, because those look quite nice. Control D, turn it off. And there we go. So I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. Oh, by the way, a lot of people don't realize that when I do these tutorials on YouTube, I also post the written step-by-steps on photoshopcafe.com. So check those out and you'll see the link there in the comments to that. And I'm curious if you learned anything new in this tutorial, drop a comment and let me know. And if you're new, welcome to the cafe. Hit the subscribe button, turn on notifications, and you won't miss any of my tutorials. And until next time, I'll see you at the cafe.